Hello, this is Randy DeLong again with High Performance Aviation. We're looking at tips and tricks on the G1000. Today we're going to look at diverting. Normally in the G1000, you fly in a nice straight line to where you want to go, but sometimes you got to go around weather, airspace, TFRs, and sometimes you just want to divert to another airport for whatever reason. It could be an emergency, or you just want to stop and get something to eat. Well, today we're going from Salina, Kansas, down to Dallas-Fort Worth. And we're en route here, and you can see ahead here on the MFD that we have a little bit of weather. What I want to do is I want to divert just a little bit to the right of course here and try to find the lighter rain. And the way I'm going to do that is I'm going to turn my range knob on, and then using the joystick, I'm going to move that map pointer down to the area that I think is the lightest and where I want to go to. Now, what I'm going to do next is go direct to that fix. So I'm going to press my direct to key, and it says you want to go to this map waypoint. I'm going to press enter, enter to activate. Now, if we look at our PFD, you can see that I had the autopilot set to nav, GPS is going to turn and start taking us to that map waypoint. So let's go back to the MFD. I'm going to go ahead and turn this map pointer off. So we're headed direct to this waypoint that we built. And after we get there, we want to continue on to Dallas. So what I want to do is press the flight plan key. Okay. And you can see in the flight plan, we're direct to the map waypoint, but we're not using the flight plan portion. So I'm going to turn my FMS knob on, and I'm going to move down to the first blank en route spot. And I'm going to put that map waypoint, just like it says, map WPT. And the way I'm going to do that is I'm going to turn my small knob to the left. Okay. I don't see it here in the flight plan. I'm going to turn the small FMS knob to the right and recent. There's my map waypoint right there. I'm going to press enter to load it into the flight plan. Press enter again. And you can see now that we have map waypoint in here. I'm going to turn the cursor off with the FMS knob. Now you can see we're headed direct to the map waypoint. Afterwards, we'll continue on to Dallas-Fort Worth. So that's a quick and easy way to move left or right of course, to go around weather, or to go around airspace. All right, I'm going to turn the flight plan key off. So let's just say we just don't want to fly through that weather. We're going to land somewhere, get ourselves something to eat, and wait for that weather to move on out of the way. So what I want to do now is I want to go to the nearest page group. So I'm going to turn my FMS knob, and I'm going to use the large knob to come down here to the nearest page group. And the first page group here is airports. I turn the knob, turn the FMS knob on one more time. We can see that there's intersections, NDBs, VORs, and a bunch of other places. But we're interested in airports right now. So I want to turn my cursor on, and you can see the airplane symbol here, and it's giving us a line to that airport. And as we go through that list, you can see that line points to the next airport. There's one behind us. What we want to do is we want to go over here to Hutchinson, Kansas. So with Hutchinson highlighted, I'm going to press direct to again. Okay. I'm going to press enter, enter to activate. Now we're going to turn and we're going to fly directly to Hutchinson, Kansas. Okay. We're not too far away from it. So what I want to do is load the frequencies, and you can see the frequencies down here. And the way I'm going to do that is I'm going to press this soft key that says frequency. I want to listen to the ATIS, so I'm going to press enter, and it's going to load it to wherever my blue box is up here. I'm going to move the blue box down to COM2, press enter. You can see it loaded it into the frequency. I'm going to put it in the active, and I can listen to it on my radio headset. Okay, I'm going to press in on the COM knob to move that blue tuning box back up. And next, I want to load in the tower frequency. So I'll press enter again. It loads it in. We transfer it over. And we can talk to the tower and tell them we're coming in to land. So that's diversions with the G1000. Hopefully this is helpful to you. Let me go ahead and turn this blinking cursor off. If you have any questions, please leave it in the comments. We would like it if you like us. And if you have anything in the G1000 that you're having trouble with, send us a message and hopefully we can help you with that. You have a good day, and we'll see you next time on G1000 Tips and Tricks.